Philadelphia, the city of brotherly love, but also the home to one of the storied franchises in NBA history. The city has seen it all. Acrobatic, legendary small forwards, feisty and smooth high-scoring guards, dominant centers on both ends of the floor, rampaging power forwards flying from baseline to baseline, all while tallying 8 finals appearances and 3 titles in its 7-decade history. Let's turn back time to journey with the Sixers. The Philadelphia 76ers started their journey in the city of Syracuse and were then known as the Syracuse Nationals. They joined the NBA in the 1950 season, led by a 21-year-old Dolph Schayes. The Sixers made the finals in their very first season, but that was just the beginning. Schayes was such a driving force for the franchise that they would not miss the playoffs for as long as he was in uniform. Over the next decade, they would make an appearance at the Eastern Conference Finals 7 times. But the most memorable one came in 1955. After losing to the Los Angeles Lakers in the 1954 NBA Finals, the Nationals broke the ceiling in 1955. They beat the Boston Celtics and the Fort Wayne Pistons en route to the first title in franchise history. As the decade was coming to a close, Schayes was beginning to age, and the team needed a new leader. Enter Hal Greer. Picked in the 1958 draft, Greer, a high-scoring guard, would go on to play 15 seasons in the franchise. He accumulated more than 21,000 points in over 1,100 games for the franchise. Schayes and the Nationals found their heir apparent. The 60s was just as rollicking for the franchise. In 1963, after 14 seasons in Syracuse, the franchise shifted its base to the city of Philadelphia and renamed itself the 76ers. Despite the move, they barely missed a step and continued to make an appearance in the playoffs. Along the way, they went shopping for a big man to compete with the Boston Celtics' Bill Russell. In the 1965 season, they found their man in Wilt Chamberlain. Chamberlain had led the NBA in rebounding 4 times and in scoring 5 times. So when a trade deal was available, the Nationals snapped up the 7-foot-1-inch center. He would go on to play 4 seasons with the Sixers, but in that time, he led the NBA in scoring once and in rebounding 3 times.
With 12 seconds left, King buried the foul shot to give Syracuse a 92-91 lead.
So dominant was Chamberlain that he won 3 consecutive regular season MVP trophies between 66 and 68. But that was the tip of the iceberg. In 1967, led by Chamberlain, Greer, and an incredible cast featuring forwards Chet Walker and Billy Cunningham, the team belted out its best season ever. First, they finished the regular season with 68 wins, the franchise's best record to date, and the 5th greatest record in NBA history. Then in the playoffs, they took care of business one by one. First, the Cincinnati Royals in 4 games, Bill Russell and the Boston Celtics in 5 games. And then, Chamberlain's former team, the San Francisco Warriors, in 6 games. The Sixers were champions again, and this time in their new hometown. They enter the new decade with 3 more consecutive playoffs appearances. The 70s started slow for the franchise. After a playoff run in 1971, an aging roster coupled with superstars moving to different pastures saw the team have some dark seasons. Fortunes turned in the 1976 season when they once again made the playoffs for the first time in 5 seasons. Led by 24-year-old Doug Collins and new teammate George McInnes, who came over in the offseason, the Sixers finished with 46 wins and the 4th seed. Despite losing in the first round to the Buffalo Braves, things were starting to look up for the franchise. The franchise hoped the 77 season would be better and to ensure that they brought in a star to light up the arenas. Julius Erving, aka Dr. J, was a 6-foot-7-inch high-flying scoring forward. He enthralled the Sixers and the NBA fans with an array of moves, the likes of which very few NBA players possessed. He finished his career with the Sixers, tallying over 18,000 points, 5,000 rebounds, and 3,000 assists. He got to work immediately, averaging 21.6 points and 8.5 rebounds per game. Irving led the Sixers to 50 wins for the first time in 8 years. With Collins and McGinnis alongside Irving, the Sixers stomped onto the 1977 NBA playoffs like a team on a mission. They took care of business against the Boston Celtics in round one and then needed just 6 games to eliminate the Houston Rockets.
Sixers against the Portland Trailblazers.
Back in the finals, they played a hard-fought series against the Portland Trailblazers. Led by a moppy-head Bill Walton and coach Jack Ramsey at the helm, the Trailblazers took care of the Sixers in just 6 games. The Sixers once again fortified their roster, drafting Maurice Cheeks in the 1978 NBA draft. Cheeks finished his career and is still in the top 10 of nearly all important statistical categories for the Sixers. But most importantly, he is the all-time leader in assists for the Sixers franchise. Over 6,000 assists dished out, with Cheeks running point and new coach Billy Cunningham, a former player for the franchise. The Sixers embarked on another finals run, this time in 1980. They racked up 59 wins in the regular season, but their goal was the title. The playoffs were a breeze. The Washington Bullets in 2 games, the Atlanta Hawks in 5 games, and the Boston Celtics in 5 games. Next up, the mighty Lakers, led by Kareem Abdul-Jabbar and a rookie, Irvin Magic Johnson. The series was hotly contested, and the Sixers even had a shot, with Kareem getting injured and not being able to play a Game 6. But despite Dr. J's magical layup, one of the greatest layups in NBA history, the Lakers pulled off a victory behind Finals MVP Johnson. The 80s would get better. 62 wins in 1981, including an MVP for Irving and an NBA Finals trip in 1982. But the crowning glory of the franchise was the 1983 season. After signing Moses Malone in the offseason, the Sixers felt confident they had it all in place. After all, Malone was a guarantee for 25 points and 15 rebounds every game.
Maybe the best offensive rebounder in the history of the game.
Pair that up with 30 points from Irving and Andrew Toney and throw in Cheeks 7 assists a game. The Sixers were the team to beat. And they barely got beaten that season. Five wins in the regular season, the second best record in franchise history. So good was the team that Malone famously predicted 4-4-4, insinuating that they would sweep their way to an NBA title. They got close. While they did sweep the New York Knicks in round one, the Milwaukee Bucks managed to sneak in a win in the Eastern Conference Finals. In the finals, the Sixers faced no trouble at all, sweeping the mighty Lakers in the NBA Finals. The franchise did it again. Title number 3 in the bag. Malone hit the double whammy. He took home regular season MVP and NBA Finals MVP in 1983. The franchise made the playoffs in 7 of the next 8 seasons. But with Malone leaving in 1986 and Irving retiring in 87, the Sixers needed a new face. They found their man in the 1984 NBA draft. With the 5th pick, the Sixers took Charles Barkley, a 6'7" beast of a player that terrified opponents both on the offensive and defensive end. His ability to run the floor like a guard and finish ferociously made him one of the most feared offensive players in the NBA. He would play just 8 seasons with the Sixers, but in that short time, amassed enough numbers to be in the top 10 of every important statistical category. With Barkley in charge, the Sixers made the playoffs in 6 out of 8 seasons. When he moved on in 1992, the Sixers were left wanting for a star. The 90s were fairly lackluster. The team did not make the playoffs for seven seasons straight. But in 1996, they found a new hero. Allen Iverson, a point guard from Georgetown, was the first pick in the 1996 NBA draft. Iverson embraced the city as much as the fans embraced him. He became synonymous with the franchise, finishing his Sixers career with nearly 20,000 points. Still the second highest mark in franchise history. With Iverson in the lead and a playoff appearance in 1999 and 2000, the franchise sought to start the millennium with a bang. And that is precisely what they did. They racked up 56 wins in the regular season, their best record in 15 years. The team's roster was composed of a motley but incredibly effective crew, featuring names such as Dikembe Mutombo, Theo Ratcliffe, Aaron McKee and Eric Snow. These were not the very biggest names out there, but they knew how to win. And they had Iverson, the 2001 regular season MVP. The Sixers took that mindset into the playoffs and got to work. They took just four games to beat the Indiana Pacers in round one. Then they played two legendary seven-game series back-to-back. The Toronto Raptors and Vince Carter were a tough task in the Eastern Conference semifinals. But despite Carter's Game 3 performance, in which he scored 50 points, it was Iverson who led the Sixers to the next round. In this series, Iverson also became the only NBA player to score 50-plus points twice in the same series. Next were the Milwaukee Bucks and their three-headed attack. Led by Ray Allen, Glenn Robinson and Sam Cassell, the Bucks threw everything they had at the Sixers. Once again, Iverson, who had two games with 40-plus points, and the Sixers proved to be too good, taking the series in seven games. Then came the mighty Lakers. Everyone believed this series was a sweep, so dominant were the Lakers. Not the Sixers. Behind a heroic 48 points from Iverson, the Sixers stunned the Lakers in Game 1, winning it 107-101. The NBA world was put on notice. But despite a career-high 35.6 points for Iverson, the Sixers could not overcome the Lakers, who took home the series in five games. From there, the Sixers made seven of the next 11 playoffs to kick off the new millennium. Iverson had moved on in a trade in 2007, but the franchise saw some other names suit up. Andre Iguodala, Chris Webber, Derek Coleman, Elson Brand and Glenn Robinson were just some of the big names that spent time in Philadelphia. But there wasn't much fanfare. Starting with the 2013 season, the Sixers missed the playoffs for five straight seasons, the second longest drought in their history. But they were building for the future. Between 2014 and 2017, the Sixers had four lottery picks. In 2014, they picked Joel Embiid with the third pick. In 2015, they picked Jahlil Okafor with the third pick. In 2016, they picked Ben Simmons with the first pick. And in 2017, they picked Markel Fultz with the first pick. And while Embiid is the only player of the four that still plays for the Sixers, the other three were moved around and traded for key pieces of the franchise as it stands today. The Sixers once again tasted playoff success in 2018 when they finished with 52 wins and the third seed in the East. Then, they beat the Miami Heat in five games. But the Boston Celtics, led by rookie Jason Tatum and Terry Rozier, took them down in five games in the Eastern Conference semifinals. Since then, the Sixers have yet to miss the playoffs. Joel Embiid, the new face of the franchise, finished 2022 as the runner-up in the regular season MVP voting. He is considered by many seasoned NBA fans and veterans to be one of the most talented big men in the history of the NBA. He can score, shoot from beyond the arc, rebound, and defend with the best of them. He even led the NBA in scoring in 2022, a feat last achieved by a Sixers player when Iverson did it way back in 2005. He also joins Russell Westbrook as the only two players to average at least 30 points and 10 rebounds in a single season since Karl Malone did it in 1990. In 2022, the team also added James Harden, a former MVP and prolific scorer of the ball, giving up Ben Simmons for the bargain in a mid-season trade. And it also featured a young dynamic guard in Tyrese Maxey, who showed tremendous promise in the 2022 playoffs. They finished 2022 with 51 wins, their third 50-win season in the last five seasons. Locking in the fourth seed, the Sixers went to work in the playoffs. They first beat a resilient but struggling Raptors team in six games. Embiid was magnificent in the series, finishing with averages of 26.2 points, 11.3 rebounds, and shooting 52% from the field. Harden was right on his heels. But the surprise breakout was Tyrese Maxey, who averaged a then-playoff series career high of 21.3 points, including 38 points in a Game 1 win in the series. The Sixers kept themselves in the next series as well. They evened things up by winning games 3 and 4 after going down 2-0. But despite some breakout players and having a healthy Harden, the Sixers fell to the Miami Heat in 6 games. Embiid missed 2 games in the series. This past season, the Sixers got even better. They finished the 2023 season with 54 wins, their best record since winning 56 games in their 2001 campaign. Harden kept his foot on the pedal, finishing the season with averages of 21 points and 10.7 assists, the best mark in the NBA. Even Maxey continued to live up to the hype, finishing with a career-high 20.3 points. But the story of the 2023 Philadelphia 76ers season had to be Joel Embiid. It wasn't just the career-high 59 points and 7 blocks in a win against the Utah Jazz on November 13th. It wasn't just that he finished the season averaging 33.1 points per game to lead the NBA in scoring, becoming the first 76er since Allen Iverson to win the award twice and in consecutive seasons. But it was the MVP award that Embiid won after putting on such an impressive regular season. With it, Embiid became just the fifth franchise player to win the award. They started on the postseason in style, sweeping the Brooklyn Nets, never allowing their opponents to get into any kind of rhythm. It was against the Boston Celtics, however, the Sixers would be tested. After trading punches, the Sixers found themselves up 3-2, going into a closeout Game 6. Alas, the Celtics proved to be too strong and won the last two games, closing out the series in 7 games. However, while the 2023 playoffs campaign ended in a conference semi-finals loss, there is little doubt that the Embiid-Harden pairing and the crew will set scoring records moving forward. Only time will tell how close the team can get to a title number 4.